Hi, I'm Benjamin von Eckertsberg and I'm the scenarist of Gung Ho. Gung Ho is an expression, it's from Chinese and also used in Japan, and it means something like to work together in harmony. And it's also an expression for people who want to manage a company, how they bring together the workers of the company in a good style for a productive environment. But also it was a battle cry in the Second World War of Marines, and then it went viral in its expression in the English language, and it means something like to be very excited about something. And for our story, it's teenagers in a post-apocalyptic scenario, and there are a lot of rules for survival. And the adults want them to be gung-ho in a positive way, you know, to follow the rules and to keep the company, the society safe. But the children and the teenagers, they kind of pervert the expression to be gung-ho about something, to do stupid stuff. So it's a little mixture of different meanings. Well, we are older than our character, so you lose about something of that over the years. But sometimes, of course.
Yeah, in earlier days he was very gung-ho. Me not, I was very serious for all the time. Normally you find in post-apocalyptic stories the world is always gray because it's always went down, you know, before. We wanted to tell the story about these teenagers, you know, in this dangerous surrounding. We wanted to have really a nice surrounding, nice setting, like it could be a holiday camp or something. It's a good thing to have this contraire things between the happy life and the romance, but also the dangerous surrounding.
Idea I had when I saw an illustration for an advertising, and there would be a lot of stuff going on in this illustration, and in one little corner there was a traffic light standing on a hill with yellow grass, so no street where the traffic light is, so just like from an ancient civilization in a way, you know. And I just imagined teenagers sitting around that and smoking and chilling and having fun, but also some of them had to guard with weapons because there could be some monsters coming out of the woods or something. So that was a kind of clicking, and we took it from there. Yeah.
Benjamin was telling me this idea, and back then we were on a signing trip, and then we were in Amiens, and we were playing around with this idea and with this environment, and we said, okay, the threat cannot come through water, and in Amiens there was a nice part of the city with where you have a canal system, you know, with the water around the houses, and we said, yeah, maybe it's like here, you know, and we started playing around, and and so he developed it further the following years, and
First I had kind of the world and the rules, and the plot and the characters came later, so it was a long process in the back of our heads.
Go get it!
Yes, really.